Now do you understand how it works?
Perfectly. I also understand compressors have come a long, long way, no
doubt. That they have.
Hey, welcome to Truck U. I'm Matt Steele.
Hi, I'm Bruno Massel.
Now, last time we were here, we had a very important decision to make. That was, which compressor are we going to go with? Will it be the QT Extreme from Quincy, the reciprocating type right there, 5 horsepower, very nice option, or will it be right over here, big 20 horsepower QGD from Quincy, direct drive, rotary screw type? Which one's it going to be? Well, we have made a decision.
And the winner is the reciprocating compressor, and the reason why, quite frankly, it fits our needs. The other one is really overkill for what we're doing here. You know, we don't need continuous duty. We don't need pumping out a lot of air all day long. What it'll do is it'll just waste energy. You know, so that's something we're not all about.
We need it whenever we want it, right? We want it to be quiet and we want it to be there on demand. And this is exactly what we need.
Now, Matt mentioned quiet, and that is one of the big factors with this we like, because a lot of people say rotaries are quieter in nature versus reciprocating.
Yeah, fewer moving parts.
Yeah, but when you throw a canopy over like this, it's really nice and quiet. So I don't have to shout whenever I want you to bring me some tools, because you're always off running off anywhere.
Okay, now let's take a look at this, because another thing real good is about both of these is the maintenance. So you take a look at this, all right? You can get right up in there. Everything is easily accessible. Man, there's really nothing better than brand new big tools, man. How pretty is that?
Yeah, it's nice because we can maintain it ourselves, the filters, the oil changes, everything we can get at, and something you can do at home yourself. All right, let's get that one out of the way, and then we can start installing this.
Why don't you pick that up and throw that on your shoulder?
A normal day at the shop, right?
Yeah, right? Rah!
So the first thing we did was have an electrician come out and put in our new power box here. And the reason why is we had the old compressor was hardwired in and we wanted to use a plug-in mode. So we've got a plug here, we can plug it in. We know that our electricity is going to be good. No one's going to get hurt and no one's going to mess up our air compressor. So now we can move on.
That gives us a lot more freedom too. If we want to get back there and clean it out for some routine, you know, maintenance or doing whatever, it just does give us more freedom. So that's always a good idea.
And we went ahead and made a bracket with the new tool we've got in the shop. I'll show you a little bit later, but this little bracket is going to be the home of another element here.
Yeah, very cool. Now this is the dryer, and that bracket right there is going to hold the dryer. Now the dryer is a good idea to have in any kind of compressor system right there, because, you know, as the compressor pulls the air out and pressurizes it, it's going to get a little bit of moisture in there. You don't want that moisture going down your air lines and getting inside your pneumatic tools. That can spell all kinds of disaster and big problems down the road.
Yep.
And that's where this dryer is going to come in. So this is going to be a nice thing, but we want to figure out where we're going to put it, right? We don't want to leave it on the ground. We could drive into it, roll the skateboards into it, kick this thing, get it all dirty. This way we pick it up, we keep it clean, and we get it up here and out of the way, and the whole system is a lot more compact. So let me get this.
You got that? Yeah, this way we can sweep around it. We're not going to sweep dust and dirt into it, so it'll keep it functioning correctly for a long period of time.
All right, so we'll get this in place. It's just got, a lip on there. Yeah, it'll burn your finger off.
Yeah, I put the lip on there so it wouldn't fall off.
Cool. Nice. All right. Well, that's pretty close. That's where it's going to go. Now we can get into the back and start making some of those connections. The first thing we want to do is we went to our buddy's shop down there at the hose store, basically got this made up, all right? Little high pressure hose. That's going to go from the bottom of the tank to the back right in here. So the air is going to come out of the tank and go into the dryer, and then it's going to go out the back into that.
Now, this is an ambient air filter. It is our last line of defense before it hits your air tool. So it'll keep dust and debris, the last set of it, of getting into your tools. One thing you want to do is go ahead and put a little Teflon tape on either end to keep sure that it seals up well and you won't have any air leaks. So take the extra minute and do that first. So the air filter will go on place here. Get it out of your way, and then you can install your black hose.
Then you have got nice, clean, dry air going down your lines. All right, so we've got the hose right up there. What we need to do is just get everything tightened up, make sure these connections are ready to go. Then we can get this a little bit closer to the wall and plug it in, and we should be ready to roll.
Yeah, sounds good. All right, our last air line is nice and tight now. Now, we've also noticed that our optional dryer is already running, and per the instructions, it tells you to go ahead and fire it up a few minutes before, because it's got refrigerant in it. Get it going before you fire up the air compressor. All I have to do now is open the valve and plug it in, and we should be about ready to rock.
Now, this is the final resting place for our compressor, and I think it's gonna look good right here, and it's definitely gonna help us get a lot of work done. You know, another thing that I like about these Quincy compressors is these are engineered, manufactured right here in the USA, so that is very, very cool indeed. And they're covered by what they call the True Blue Warranty. That's a 5-year warranty. These guys are gonna stand behind their product and take care of any problems, which you're not gonna have anyway. But it's nice to know that they got it covered.
I wanna hear it. That's the important thing for
us. Ready,
dude? Yep.
Let's fire her up right there.
And that is not bad at all.
We talked about how quiet this thing was and that we're not gonna have to scream at each other, and that is exactly the case. This is good. So you know the deal now, right? We have got air. We have got air pressure, and we have got tools, and we have work to do. We're gonna get to all of that when we come back right after this.